Is there any benefit to joint supplements given in feed? Ooh, scandalous question. I have been told they are helpful, but also that horses do not metabolize them when given this way, and injections are better. Is this true? Great question. I'm really glad we get to talk about this.
I am too. I actually found two, now I can show you this, two pages of research. There's tons and tons, but
These are just the names of the studies, and it's two pages worth.
Yeah.
This isn't like the research.
No. These are just the citations themselves. And it's got to do from everything, your main ingredients, your glucosamine, chondroitin sulfate, HA, MSM, the bioavailability, because I think that was one part of her question, as well as the efficacy, and some of them, the safety. And so one of them, here's this one, the effect of MSM on biomarkers of oxidative stress in sport horses following jumping exercise. It doesn't get much more specific than that. So these guys conducted a great experiment and showed that a very, very common joint supplement was not only taken in orally, got to the tissues it needed to get to, but it had a positive effect. So there's one here from a very well-known surgeon, Larry Bramlage. He gave oral HA to young thoroughbreds that had OCD, like chip removal surgeries, mm-hmm. and found that the treatment group that got the HA had less swelling and pain than the group that didn't. So we're not supposed to say those words, but that's what the research says. I mean, it's hard to talk about the research when that's what it says. So, but here's bioavailability, pharmacokinetics of glucosamine and chondroitin sulfate. I mean, there's tons and tons of research out there. I pulled these from Astavet blogs.
Mm.
So there's probably a half a dozen entries in.
Those are written by a pretty smart lady.
Well, I'd done the work already. So I knew these studies were up there already. So if you want to find them, we can probably put a link
in
on
the video,
this video
description. Yep.
But that's where the link is going to take you to the Astavet blogs, because they're all there.
And so the important words that you heard at the beginning were bioavailability, so can your horse absorb it, and then efficacy, does it work?
And safety. There's some safety studies in here too, yeah.
Yeah, for sure. But hopefully you guys know what that one means. And so it's nice to see that there's research on all of those things, proving mm-hmm. and reinforcing it. I do want to talk just for a minute,
This one I like, sure.
Yeah, go for it.
Well, this is the one that Martha Rogers did that said, consistent use of an oral glucosamine chondroitin supplement, this was in a barn of hunter jumpers, reduced the need for hock joint injections. So they were able to spread the injections out farther and get more performance out of the horses, spending less money,
yeah.
basically. So it shows the combination of oral supplements for joints with other methods.
Yeah, so not that they work better, they work differently.
They work together,
and they're complementary.
There you go, yeah.
Just like us. I like to think so. I did want to talk about one thing you said,
yes.
in terms of that we can't talk about it, or that we're not supposed to talk mm-hmm. about it. And this is something that I think we don't talk a lot about.
Because we're not supposed to.
Because we're not supposed to. But there's differences between supplements and pharmaceuticals, like drugs.
Right.
That go through like rigorous testing.
Yep.
And so that's why we're not allowed to say things that are disease or condition terms, mm-hmm. like arthritis or inflammation, because those can only be treated by drugs. But supplements can help support normal function, so if those things are a concern for you, it might be wise to be supporting your horse with a supplement. But those are hard connections for us to make, and so that's why we avoid those words, and
yeah.
that's why you don't see SmartPak ever saying, "Here's arthritis." There are companies out there that say it
yeah.
about supplements, and they shouldn't.
Right.
And so kind of a rule of thumb I think about when looking at supplements is if it sounds too good to be true,
it
might
is.
Be.
Yeah.
And so that's you can read all about NASC guidelines on our website. We'll include a link to that. That's the National
okay.
Animal Supplement Council. And they help us regulate the industry so that you guys can feel confident when you're shopping for supplements,
mm-hmm,
that
mm-hmm.
you know that you're buying from a trustworthy vendor.
Yeah, because there's a seal on it. Yeah.
Yeah.
That was very well said. So
Thank you.
Yeah.
I could tell you were a little bit nervous.
Ah,
we were getting into
complete
it.
Complete confidence.
It's true. I mean, we can always edit it out. If it went horribly awry, you guys wouldn't even know.
Right.